I'm looking at you straight in the eye. I look everyone straight in the eye. I must say it wasn't a pleasure talking to you. Namaste.
They say one woman, many roles. Indeed, a woman plays several roles in her life and defines her strength. From being an obedient daughter to being a mother who set Guinness World Record for her foster son's marriage reception, from being a successful actor from childhood to a 6 times chief minister. Jairam Jayalalitha has shown that there was something special about her. She overcame everything that was meant to destroy her.
Koi jadoo nahi, sirf mehnat hai.
This video is dedicated to the life of Tamil Nadu's beloved politician, Amma, or as most of us know, Jayalalitha. But before proceeding, please subscribe to our channel and hit the bell icon. Jayalalitha was born on 24th February 1948 in Melkote, Karnataka. When she was just 2, her father passed away, and to support the family, her mother Sandhya went to Chennai to pursue acting career while Jayalalitha stayed at Bangalore for studies. She was a very bright student and won gold medal for scoring the highest in 10th standard in Tamil Nadu boards. Jayalalitha's talent wasn't just limited to academics, she learned different dance forms such as Bharatanatyam, Kathak, Mohiniyattam and Manipuri.
I had come to Madras to be with my mother during the summer vacation. My mother was an actress and she was acting in a Kannada film called Sri Shaila Mahatmya. I had gone to the studios to be with my mother and the child artist who was to play Goddess Parvati fell ill and could not turn up for shooting that day. So when the producer and the director saw me there with my mother, they asked her whether she would allow me to play that role that day. So my mother said yes. So that was the first time I donned makeup and appeared before the cameras.
She acted for almost 2 decades and worked in around 125 films, including Tamil, Telugu, Kannada, and Hindi language movies. Her acting career saw a boom in 1965 when she acted opposite legendary actor Maruthur Goplan Ramachandram, popularly known as MGR. The on-screen couple was so much loved by the public that they worked together for 27 more films. Jayalalitha was such a talented actress that she won Tamil Nadu State Award for Best Actress for 5 years. She also won 3 Filmfare Awards for Best Actress. There's a famous quote, "Don't be a woman that needs a man, be a woman that a man needs." Jayalalitha indeed stood up to this and started her political career in 1982 when she joined AIADMK on request of MGR, who was the founder of party and the then Chief Minister of Tamil Nadu.
I came to politics only because he invited me to do so, only to be of help to him. I never had any personal ambition.
Being naturally blessed to grasp almost anything quickly, politics also wasn't far from her reach, and she soon became very close aide of MGR and handled several rallies and public speeches when he was ill on her own. In 1983, she was made the propaganda secretary of the party, and within 1 year, she was elected to the Rajya Sabha in 1984 when AIADMK won assembly elections and MGR was made chief minister for the 3rd time. However, things didn't really go smooth for her. MGR was admitted to hospital due to severe health conditions and her wife Janki removed Jayalalitha as leader of parliamentary party in 1985. In 1987, MGR passed away and Jayalalitha was disrespected publicly when she was pushed off during funeral procession. In 1988, Janki was sworn in as the chief minister after winning the no confidence motion. However, it wasn't soon that she had to leave her chair after the then PM Rajiv Gandhi dismissed her government and called out for re-elections. The Tamil Nadu state came under president's rule that time. In 1989, Jayalalitha gave up her Rajya Sabha seat to contest elections and no prize for guessing, she won and became the first female opposition leader in Tamil Nadu from the AIADMK party. Once she won the elections, Janki left politics and Jayalalitha successfully united both the factions. She was elected as the general secretary of the party. March 25th, 1989, the date that brought with it a dark, shameful incident in not just Jayalalitha's life, but everyone in politics. AIADMK's main political rival in the state, the DMK party leaders, manhandled her during a tensed argument over state budget as it became violent. A strong woman is not the one who doesn't cry. A strong woman is the one who cries, sheds tears, and gets up to fight back. This is exactly what Jayalalitha did. She vowed to return to the assembly only as a chief minister and rule the state. In 1991 elections, her victory was overwhelming and she took oath as the youngest chief minister the state had ever seen at the age of 43. In her first term, she took a lot of steps towards women empowerment and industrialization, such as 30% quota in police, dedicated police stations and libraries for women. She also successfully attracted several overseas automobile companies to set up their manufacturing unit in Tamil Nadu. She also introduced the Cradle Baby scheme to fight against female infanticide. However, her tenure wasn't all smooth. There were several corruption cases against her, and many people blamed her close aide Shashikala for it.
She's a much misunderstood and maligned person, and she has been the target of a lot of vilification and persecution simply because of her loyalty to me and her closeness to me.
It was Shashikala's nephew who was adopted by Jayalalitha, and in 1995 she threw a grand reception for his wedding, making a Guinness World Record for hosting over 150,000 guests. She had to face a lot of questions and controversies for this, since she took just 1 rupee as salary. As a result of all allegations against Jayalalitha, 1996 elections were a massive disappointment, and Jayalalitha herself was defeated in Bangur. The DMK party came in power again and bombarded Jayalalitha with around 40 corruption cases. Subramaniam Swamy, the then Janata Party chief, also filed a disproportionate assets case against her in 1996. As a result of investigations, 10,000 plus saris, 750 plus pairs of footwear, 28 kgs of gold, 90 plus watches and 800 kgs silver were seized during a raid. In December the same year, she was imprisoned for a month, and the move, it is said, was planned by the sitting DMK chief minister M. Karunanidhi. Once out from the jail, Jayalalitha involved herself more in national politics, and she joined the 1998 NDA coalition, but on a few terms. She wanted all cases against her to be dismissed and the DMK government be toppled. Atal Bihari refused, and then happened the infamous Tea Party led by Subramaniam Swamy in 1998. In this party, Swamy brought together Jayalalitha and Sonia Gandhi.
I do not want to discuss Mrs. Sonia Gandhi in this interview.
Not really sure what went inside, but just 2 weeks later, Jayalalitha withdrew her support from NDA and Atal Bihari's government toppled. In 2000, she was convicted from the 1996 corruption case filed against her, and she wasn't allowed to contest 2001 elections. However, AIADMK still won, and Jayalalitha took oath as the chief minister for second time. Revenge is a dish best served cold. Jayalalitha, after becoming the CM, didn't wait too long to put her hands on M. Karunanidhi. He was arrested from his house during night in a very embarrassing manner, like some roadside criminal in a flyover scam.
I languished in jail for 28 days in a case in which I was ultimately acquitted.
So was it
when
revenge?
Mr. Karunanidhi did this, the media gave him kudos for throwing me into jail, portraying it as a triumph of good over evil. It was not vengeance, he was involved in a corruption case.
Since Jayalalitha was convicted for criminal acts, Supreme Court in December 2001 ruled that she could not be the chief minister. As a result, Jayalalitha resigned and O. Panneerselvam took oath as the new CM. In 2003, Madras High Court ruled in her favor and she was acquitted. After 6 months, she won the by-polls and took her oath as the chief minister for the third time. During this regime, she introduced India's first company of female police commandos. The government banned sale of lotteries and gutkas or pan masalas. Not just this, the infamous dacoit Virappan was also killed in 2004, and she applauded the special forces to secure the mission. She launched rainwater harvesting scheme to rejuvenate water sources, which was appreciated around the nation and even adopted by some other states. In 2004, the state was hit by a tsunami, and her situation handling skills were so good, even the then PM Manmohan Singh praised her. People started calling her the Iron Lady. Despite everything, her party didn't perform in the 2006 elections and DMK formed a coalition government in Tamil Nadu. Time passed and in 2011 elections, AIADMK again performed well, leading to Jayalalitha's fourth swearing in as the CM. She started her term drawing everyone's attention towards her social welfare schemes, such as the launch of subsidized Amma products. Goods such as Amma bottled water, Amma salt and Amma cement were launched at cheap price for the public. Even a scheme called Amma Canteen was launched, which served meals for just rupee 1. Jayalalitha's government also distributed laptops to students from rural areas who cleared 10th and 12th exams to encourage digital education. Later that year, she expelled Shashikala and her family members from the party, but took her back after a year once she received an apology letter from her. In 2014 though, the old, disproportionate assets case haunted her and a special court in Bangalore ruled against her. She was sentenced 4 years imprisonment and a fine of 100 crores was also levied. She was automatically disqualified as a CM and had to leave the chair. Public's love for their Amma showed in different forms, some protesting violently and some non-violently. She spent around 21 days in jail and got bail from Supreme Court. People gathered in masses to welcome her back and show support. In 2015, Special Bench of Karnataka High Court acquitted Jayalalitha and she was sworn in as the CM for fifth time. Her government initiated Global Investors Summit in 2015, which brought in around Rs 2.4 lakh crore worth of investments to the state. She also launched Amma Master Health Checkup Plans, where people could get their medical tests done at very cheap prices in government facilities. In 2016, she also launched a scheme where senior citizens over 60 years of age could travel 10 times a month for free using buses. The same year in assembly elections, she again won in a row and became Tamil Nadu's CM for the sixth time. Within 100 days of victory, she wrote off several farmers' loans and gave free electricity in houses for up to 100 units. She also established Kudankulam Nuclear Power Plant. On 21st September, she made her last public appearance and inaugurated two Chennai metro lines via video conferencing. The very next day, she fell severely ill, and after several days of fighting, beloved Amma left her people weeping on 5th December 2016 due to cardiac arrest. Amma left, but her legacy lives. There is soon going to be a Bollywood movie released dedicated to Jayalalitha's life, namely Thalaivi, in different languages, where her role will be played by Kangana Ranaut. Thank you for watching till the end. Please subscribe to the channel and hit the bell icon.